Is recording on? So till now we have talked about the number system. Like we have decimal, which are maximum 10 numbers, 0 to 9, binary 0 to 1, octal 0 to 7, then hexadecimal 0 to 9, and then 10 will represent by A, then B, C, D, E, F. So these are the way how you can represent a number, right? Now let's look into how we can start counting, right? So in case of decimal, right, so we are starting like 0 to 9, and after 9 what we are getting? 10, then 11, and so on. After that we will go till 19 and then 20. And then you can say, sir, why are you saying this? Because we already know after 9 it is 10. But the question comes, what about the binary system? When we talk about binary system, this is 0, then 1. After 1, what will be the value? What do you think? What should be the value after this? 0, 1. 2 is not possible. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, nothing is in the binary. So then it will jump to the 1, 0. Then 1, 1. And after that, 100 and so on. So in that way binary works. Now if you say similar way, if we talk about the octal number, and we'll start 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. After 7. What do you think? What will be the after 7? 8 is not possible. Yes, Siddhant. Siddhant, want to say something?
No, sir.
Okay. So what after 7? After 7, in case of octal, 8 is not possible. So in that case, similarly, because it is up to 9, then 9 after 9, it is 10. So here also it will be 10. Then 11 and so on. 17, after 17, it will be 20. Now, what about after 77? Once you reach 77, then what next?
100.
Exactly, then it will be 100. Similarly, as after you are reaching India 99, then you are jumping to the 100. Now if you talk about hexadecimal, same story will also work here, but instead of just numbers, we have like 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 9. Then after 9 it's A, B, C, D, E, F. After F the number will come 10. Then after 1F, the number will come 20. Then after 2F, number will come 30, and so on. So this is the way how counting works. Now this is for well-known systems, like you already know binary, octal, hexadecimal, and decimal. Now the question comes, why these number systems are there? If we already have decimal, then what is the requirement of binary? What is the requirement of octal? What is the requirement of decimal? Right, that we need to really understand why any evolution comes, why any research comes into the picture, why new things comes into the picture. So the evolution of binary will comes with the computers. Now you can say, what is the what comes, like why with computers it comes? Ultimately, I want to represent the number in the hardware, right? Here I want to represent, like this number should be stored somehow in the hardware. Now if you say hardware, what hardware supports? Hardware supports only 0, 1 with the help of some physical material, that is silica. So I think you already aware about Silicon Valley. Silicon Valley is coming from silica. Silica is one kind of material. You can say like iron or aluminium or any other material, silica is also one kind of material. Now silica has a property so that it can differentiate between 0 and 1. So means once a current will flow from the silica material, then based on this intensity of this current, it will able to identify it want to make it 0 or it want to make it 1. Or you can say there is a switch with, you can make with the silica material, with some particular voltage, the switch will be on. and if the voltage is less than that, then it will be off. So it means off and on is also treated as 0 and 1. And base, because that silica material support those things, now you can implement these numbers into the binary. So then binary evolves. So the 0, 1 concept comes from the material that support by the system. Now maybe in the long run, after some time, you will have material that can support 4 state. So then maybe in the number system will change for the computers and that will become 0, 1, 2, 3. Because now it is supporting 4 state. But till now, whatever system you are looking, you are working, these are supporting only 2 state, either 0 state and 1 state. That's why everything, whatever you are working with the laptop, desktop or this computer system, they are working with the 0 and 1s. Any doubt till this point? Anyone?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Good.
Okay.
Now,
excuse me.
Yeah, please.
Sir, can you please, instead of using this, can you please share your screen and use some app like MS Paint or something? Because afterwards, this won't get recorded in the...
because we are already recording it, so that will come into the picture.
Sir, the point is
So we get the notification saying the whiteboard won't get recorded whenever we join the meeting.
Absolutely.
Okay, so can we do next time onward? Otherwise, I have to open another slide.
So you can just use this particular one and just share your screen. It's easier that way.
Right.
Just here, what you're saying?
Just share your whiteboard page and it'll show the same thing and this whole thing will be recorded.
So I already shared it, right?
No, like integrated whiteboard won't be recorded. But
now you are using the collaborate function, sir. Instead of collaborating it, you'll have to share your screen.
Is this like some Windows whiteboard, something like that?
Yes, sir. It will be on the top if you're using the pen, right beside, sorry, on the bottom where you get the timing.
Okay, let me check.
Yeah, or just search for a whiteboard.
Okay. Yeah. Normally I'm using PPT, but for this lecture, I just tried. Whiteboard. Is there, but I think it is not installed in my system.
So you can use MS Paint instead.
You can go to the website whiteboard.microsoft.com.
Okay. Just give me a minute.
There you can directly use the whiteboard in your browser and then you can share your screen.
Yeah, so that would be better.
Is there any possibility that I can save it? Okay, just give me a minute. I will prepare. Just a minute. I have a solution, easy solution for this. Okay, so what about this, what we already done? Okay, not too much, so not a problem. Now is the white screen available for you?
Yes, sir, it's
perfect. Now it's PowerPoint.
Yes, sir.
Okay, cool. Thank you. Okay, so we was talking about like binary. So is there any doubt till that point, if you have? Why binary comes into the picture? Anyone, any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, cool. Now let's talk about octal. Why octal comes into the picture? So before jumping into the octal, let me give you one idea. Suppose you have a file. Let's say the file name is f1.someabc. Some file you have. Now what you can do with this file? What operations we can perform with this file? Suppose you have any file in the Windows or Linux or any other operating system, what different operations you can perform with this file? Yes, anyone?
So read, write, append, modify.
So you can say read. Now once you say write, means append, modify, everything will come under the write. Read, write, and what else we can do? If it is executable file, then we can execute as well. Right? So these are three main property, or you can say three properties of any file. Either you can read it, write it, or execute it, if it is executable. Now, if you look into these three property, right, you can represent this three property with a binary number. Like you can say, I want to give only read permission. Other than you, no one can write it, no one can execute it. So what you will do, you will just simply say 100. It represents you have given permission only for reading. Right. Now suppose someone say 110. What exactly it means? You can read and write. Both are possible. Now suppose you say 001. It means you can only execute, but you cannot read or write. So means with the help of binary, with the help of this 101 or 100, you can give permission to a particular file. Now if you look into the octal, it starts from 0 and go up to 7. Now I want to represent this number 0 to 7. It is first is 000. Then second value, if you are representing with the binary, then 001, then 010, and so on, you can go up to 111. Right? So simply, if you look into this and permission, so can we use octal to give permission? Is this is the most suitable number system to give the permission? What do you think? Because you required only 3-bit to represent the permission, and octal is also using only 3 bits to represent themselves, right? So that's why it is heavily used for the representation. Now, how exactly it works? Suppose you can say, so the permission is given, let's say 777, and this 777 in octal. So what exactly? I think many of you already use chmod command in Linux if you have worked with the Linux. Chmod. Chmod stands for change their operations. Mode of operations, what you can do. Chmod, this is just a Linux command, so I'm not jumping into that. You can give permission 777. Now you can say, till now we are talking about only one bit, that is 111. Now it's come three numbers, 777. It represents 111, 111, and 111. Now, why? So whenever you see the property of any file, once you open the property of any file, you will get this structure. RWX. This is given in the file whenever you open the property. What exactly this RWX means? First one is for the creator, whoever the creator of that file. What are the permission for that person? Second is for the group. Group in the sense, suppose you are in the domain of Bennett University, all the systems. So then all the systems in one group, what permission we are giving to the group. And third permission is for the outsider. If someone is accessing your file from the outside. So means whenever you say chmod 777, it means you are giving all read, write, and execute permission to everyone. That is the place where octal is used. That is the one place what you see every day, actually. This example you see every day. But in short, you can say whenever you want to represent something which is represented with the help of only 3-bit, then you can use the octal numbers. Getting everyone? Any doubt on this? Guys, any doubt?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Right. No, suppose, sir. Yeah. Yes, please.
Sir, if 7 represents like 111, then what will 6 represent?
Very nice. Suppose someone says 677. So what 6 means? 110. 7 means 111. 111. It means the outsider cannot execute, but he can read and write. Simple binary conversion.
But if we use then 3, so then what will happen? So then everything will, like, it will only, it will be 0, 0, 0 till 4 only, right? And what if we use 3 instead of 6?
3, sir?
Yes.
Yes.
Sir, just another doubt, sir. Sir, can we change, sir? I mean, 100 is permission for reading. Are they fixed or can they be modulated?
These locations are always fixed. First for reading, second for writing, third for execution.
So they won't be changed. They will always be fixed.
If you will change, then you have to write your own OS program for that. Then you can do whatever you want. Suppose you want to write your own Linux kernel, then you, it's up to you. But that should be publicized so that others can also use in the same way. Means it should be in the same standard.
Yes.
Okay. So suppose someone say, if someone given 300, let's say this is the permission you have given. So it means you are talking about 01011000000. It means outsider can write something, can execute something, but can't read something. Rest, anyone cannot do anything with that file. So this is the meaning of that representation. Yes.
So how did this happen, sir?
It is conversion.
What, sir, here what means by read? What do you mean by read?
So he cannot read because the permission is not there.
He can write or execute.
Read, write, and execute. So he has rights only for write and execute. So I'm not saying like it is possible or not. I'm saying once you represent with the 300, what is the meaning of that? Getting?
Okay. So like if we take a sample case of 377.
Okay. So that's fine. So others will get all the permission.
Yes,
and
sir. Okay.
Got it? Okay. Now let's talk about hexadecimal. So hexadecimal normally help us to represent the memory location, or you can say memory address. Right. So whenever you look into the memory address, suppose you are saying you are 32-bit system. Let me take this example. You have 32-bit system. So actually it is represented by some 32-bit 0 and 1s. 10111 something like that. Right. So this required 32-bit. To represent a location, right? Now, what hexadecimal is saying, when you look into the hexadecimal, it is start from 0, 1, 2, up to F. F means total 16 values. Now, I want to represent total 16 values, so how many bits we required? Number of bits. What do you think? How many bits required to represent total 16 values, 0 to 15? Yes,
128.
Oh my god,
four,
right? We required only 4 bit for that, right? So for example, if you are saying 0, so 0 will be represented by 000, 1 will be represented by 001, then 0010, and so on. Last F will represent by 1111. So whenever someone will ask you how many bits required to represent a number, you just check what is the maximum value. And suppose you are saying this is the 16 base. So if you just check the base, and based on that base, you just put the log base to 16. What you will get? You will get 4. Now you can say how you will get. Let me do that as well. 2 to the power 4. If you do it, you will get 4 value. Getting? So from there, you can extract how many bits required to represent this big number, right? Now, suppose someone say, if you have 10 bits available with you. Suppose I'm saying I have 10 bit address. So how many numbers we can represent with this 10 bit? What do you think? How many numbers we can represent? Similarly, with 4 bit, we can represent 15 numbers. So with 10 bits, how many numbers we can represent?
1024.
2 to the power 10.
2 to the power 10, exactly. So 2 to the power 10 numbers you can represent. Now I'm saying I have 32 bits. So how many numbers we can represent?
2 to the power 32.
Exactly. Right, so you will get 2 to the power 32 numbers. Now we have large variety of numbers. And if like a, we will give all in the binary, then it will be very difficult to track which number we are targeting. So in order to represent is more better way, we are using hexadecimal. So for example, 32-bit system is converted into the 8 numbers. Numbers in the sense 8 different numbers. Right? Why 8 different numbers? Because every 4 bit represented by 1 number here. So in that case, what you will do? So let me take one simple example, a smaller one. Let me take the 8 bit number. Right. So what you will do? What will be this number and what will be this number? You just make, what will be this number? Can you convert into the octal? Sorry, decimal.
11.
But 11 is not available in the hexadecimal. So what 11 represents?
B.
Right. So it will become B. What about this? 10.
10.
A.
10 is A. So the number is represented by AB and the base is 16. So now instead of taking 8 bits, suppose you are giving an address to that person, to another person, and instead of just representing into 8 bits, you are representing only 2 numbers. So which one is easier to represent? 2, right? So that's why hexadecimals comes into the picture. At the end, or you can say at the end in the computer, everything is binary, but to represent them in a good way, or you can say in an efficient way, we are using hexadecimal and octals. Any doubt till this point, anyone?
So even though we represented, like we are shortening the representation, mm-hmm. but the memory will still remain the same, right?
Yes, that will remain same because memory will store only in the binary form.
Okay.
Yeah, it is just representation for us so that we can understand properly, user can understand properly.
Right, sir.
Okay. Any doubt, anyone? Okay, so now let's understand how to convert one number system to another number system, one like decimal to octal, octal to decimal, and so on. So let me give you a process. Once you'll understand, you will see a process is there. So we need to understand that process. Suppose I want to convert.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, why don't we stick to one type of system?
Because of convenient. Decimal, you don't have any physical material that can represent decimal. But as a human, we understand decimal most. So that's why decimal is there. Binary, machine understand binary only, that's why binary is there. And remaining is the representation, so that we can easily understand.
Sir, so why don't we decide one best type of representation and just use that one representation?
So why it is there? For example, as we say octal, right? Octal is using 3 bits, 1, 1, 1. And if you say hexadecimal, it is using 4 bit, let's say 1, 0, 1, 1, 4 bit number. So it is using complete 3 bit and it is using complete 4 bit, right? So means if you say we have a memory, and this memory is representing by 1010. Getting? So in case of octal, you will take complete 3 space and this will represent a complete number. Right? So whenever it is all about the efficiently use of that memory. If you required only 3 bit to represent something, why will you use 4 bit? There is no meaning to use 4 bit. And if you want to efficiently represent with 4 bits, then there is no meaning to use 3 bit because 4 bit is much more efficient and much more easy to represent. Now, if you talk about decimal, as we understand decimal much better, and we have 0 to 9, right? So if you say this 9 number, it will be 1 0 8 4 2 1 1 0 0 1, right? Now if you say 1 0 0 1, after this what will happen? It will be 10. Then you can say 1 0. So now you can say 1 will be represented by another 4 bit and 0 will be represented by another 4 bit. Means there is less efficiency in this representation format in terms of computers. But as a human, we understand this well. But as a conceptual, this is stronger. But in terms of storage, in terms of efficiency, this is not that strong. So that's why we have different number systems. Getting? It's all about efficiency. How efficiently we can use the storage and how efficiently we can understand the process. Okay. Now, suppose I want to convert decimal to binary. Let me erase this as well. Simply, what you'll do, decimal to binary. I think many of you already know. Suppose I want to convert 16. Let me take 16, and I want to convert into the binary. So what is the base for this binary? 2. Whatever the base, we'll divide by that. So it will go 8 times, remainder will be 0. Then again, it will go 4 times, remainder will be 0. 2, again, it will go 2 times, remainder will be 0. Then 2, it will go 1 time, right? And then after that, we do not need to divide because this number is smaller than this. And then you will write in this way. So what you will get? 1000. This will be binary representation of 16.
Getting? One zero is missing.
Yes. Here we also have one.
The remainder is zero there too.
So this remainder is there. So it will be 1000. 4 times 0 and 1. True. Thank you. Right. Similarly, if you look into this process, similarly, suppose I want to convert decimal to the octal. Now, what is the base for octal? 8. Suppose we have a number 38, and that I want to convert into the octal. So the base is 10. So then what you will do? 38. It's divided by 8. So what will get?
4.
And what will be the remainder?
6.
Right. Then you again divide no remainder. So the value will be 46. So that is the octal, which is represented by 3810. Right. Base 10. Now suppose I want to represent, or I want to convert decimal to the hexadecimal. Right. So in that case, hexadecimal base is 16. Suppose I have a number 116, let's say. So what you will do? You will divide by 6, 16. So what will be the remainder? What will be the value? Or let me take some simple value. I think that's simple. Yes. What
so
will
7 times.
Hmm?
7 times 112.
Yeah, and what will be the remainder?
4.
Now, if you divide by 16, it's already lesser, so means you cannot perform this.
74.
This is
the base 16. Right? So now you can see the process. Suppose instead of these well-known numbers, now I am saying I want to convert a number decimal base of 4. What you will do? And the number here is 15. What we'll do?
Divided by 4.
Divided by 4. Right?
3.
Yes, sir.
3. What will be the remainder?
3.
33 will be
3.
And then the number will be 33 in the base 4. Getting?
Yes, sir.
So you can see a process here. Process is whatever the base you want to convert, you will divide by that number and continuously you just follow the process. Now let's look into the reverse. Binary to decimal, octal to decimal, right? So let me convert binary to decimal. Right? So in that case, Suppose I have a number 101. This is in base 2 and I want to convert into the base 10. What we'll do? We'll take one number and you look into this base. 1 into 2 to the power 0 plus 0 into 2 to the power 1 plus 1 into 2 to the power 1. Sorry, 2. Right? So what number we'll get?
5 will be the right.
So we'll get the number 5. That is in base 10. Now, suppose we are saying octal to the decimal. In that case, we have number, let's say we have number 118, that is the octal, and we want to convert into the decimal. How we'll do it? We have to follow the same
process. 1 times 8 plus 8 times 1.
8 into 8 to the power 0,
plus 1 into 8 to the power 1.
Now, before doing this conversion, one more important thing that we have missed out is this is possible.
Yes, that's what I was asking.
Exactly. Yeah, this is incorrect actually. So suppose you will get this kind of question in the exam. So instead of doing this, what you have to write? Simply, you don't need to convert. Okay, so let's say we have 17 base 8 and then now I want to convert into the base 10. So then 7 into 8 to the power 0 plus 1 into 8 to the power 1. So what number we'll get? 15, right? This is the base 10. Now, similarly, if you have hexadecimal and you want to convert into the decimal, hexadecimal base is 16, right? So suppose I want to convert 1AB. This is in the hexadecimal and I want to convert into the base 10. What you will do? B into 16 to the power 0 plus A into 16 to the power 1 plus 1 into 16 to the power 2. Now what A represents? It is 10. What B represents? It is 11. So in short, it is 1 into 16 to the power 2 plus 10 into 16 to the power 1 plus 11 into 16 to the power 2. Now, if you just sum all of them, you will get the number in the decimal.
Getting 277, sir.
Yeah, whatever number I didn't calculate it. If you are saying 277, let me write it. Thank you. Getting everyone, any doubt?
Sir, can you please explain this octal to decimal once again, sir?
This one?
Why we cannot do the first case, sir? Why it's not possible?
Okay. So in case of octal, what numbers are there? 0, 1, 2, then 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. After 7, you have again 1, 0. 1, 1, 1, 7. Then again, you have 2, 0. So this 18 will never occur in this octal series.
Correct, sir. Got it.
Ready?
Sir, can you please repeat the last step?
Last step of.
Sir, can we repeat this once again?
Which one?
Sir, hexadecimal to decimal.
Okay, here. So here we have A and B. So A and B represented 10 and 11. So just we have the B into 16 to the power 0 plus A into 16 to the power 1, 1 into 16 to the power 2, right? So the A is just converted to the 10, B is converted to the 11, and 1 into, so that we can calculate actually, right? So 1 into 16 to the power 2, 10 into 16 to the power 1, 11 into 16 to the power 0. Yes?
Answer will be
427.
So I didn't know the answer. There's one person said it's 277, so I put 277. Whatever answer, just make it correct. I have not calculated. It's just, I want to explain the process only. What will be the process? Getting?
Yes, sir.
Cool. Now, there are some internal conversion as well. So, is time is permitting? Yeah, time is permitting. So, let's look into some internal conversion. So, this is all about when you want to convert from decimal or you want to convert into decimal, right? But suppose you want to convert binary to the octal. So this base is 8 and this base is 2. So there are some shortcuts as well. So suppose I want to convert binary to the octal and binary number is 10101. This I want to convert into the octal. Now if you say octal, it's a base 8 and every bit represent, every number will represent by 3 bit, right? So what we will do, we will take this number 10101 and from the back side you will make pair of 3 bits. If this is not completed, put it 0. And then you convert back to the number. So what number you will get? 010 to 1013. So the number will be 23. Getting?
Yes, sir.
It's a kind of shortcut. Similarly.
Sir, that wouldn't that be 5? 20.
So 5. Yeah. It should be 5. Instead of 23, it should be 5. 25. Good. Thank you. Okay. So now I want to convert binary to the hexadecimal. Right. So suppose we have number 1011101. This number is in the binary. I want to convert into the hexadecimal. Now, how many bits required for hexadecimal? 4. So what we'll do, we'll make pair of 4. So we'll start from here, one pair, and we'll make second pair, 0 is missing. So then what will be the number? What will be number for this? Simply you can do 8, 4, 2, 1. So it will be 5. And what about this?
B.
13. C. So then it will be A is 10, let me write it, B is 11, C is 12, and D is 13. So what 13. D, right? D. So this number will be there, 5D. Getting everyone? Any doubt on this? Guys, any doubt?
No, sir.
Now
suppose instead of these well-known number, I want to convert binary to a base of 4.
And sir, binary to hexadecimal, batana hai.
So here we are making pair of 4. So in this case, because it required 4 bit, hexadecimal required 4 bit to represent, so we are making pair of 4. Getting? And whatever value is there, that we are, so this pair is representing, this group is representing 5 and second group is representing 13 and 13 is represented by D. So we are saying 5D. Getting?
Yes, sir.
Cool. Now I want to represent binary number, which is base 2, into a number that is base 4. And suppose I have a number, let's say 101011. So then what will be the number? Now you have to do. Yes. So you will make a pair here because it's a 4, means you require 2 bit. So you'll make pair for 2, 2, 2. So it will be 223. Exactly. So this will be the number. Getting everyone? Any doubt on this?
So what if we want to change the binary into a number which has base 5?
Oh. Means you want reverse?
No, sir. Mm-hmm. Here if we replace 4 base number with base 5,
right?
Yes, sir.
In that case, yes. This shortcut will not work out. Then what you have to do, if suppose you want to convert binary that is base 2 and that is any number which is not in 2 to the powers. Let's say 2 to the power, let me say 2 to the power p. So if it is 2 to the power 1, means it is 2 to the power 2, that is itself binary, then 4, then 8, 2, 4, 8, 16, and so on. Then only you can use this shortcut. Otherwise, suppose you are saying it is base 5. So then what you have to do, first you have to convert this into the decimal, and then decimal to the base 5. This shortcut will work whenever you have a converted number system in 2 to the powers. Exact number 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, and so on. Getting?
Yes,
sir.
Yes.
Sir, if there is only one number in the left side, I mean, there is only zero, so there is only one, so we should keep rest of the digits as zeros.
Yeah, yeah, you have to put all zeros.
So, you know, if we, in order to take 3, if there are only 2 present, so we should keep the rest as 0.
Yes, yes, definitely.
Yeah.
Yeah, any other doubt, guys? Anyone?
No, sir.
Okay, that's cool. So this is like somehow related to the number system conversion, right? Now, in the next class, we'll talk about signed number. When you say plus 25 and minus 25, how we'll represent these signed number into the system. Till now we talk about only the numbers, because, and when we say how to represent into the system means we are talking about the binary system. How plus 25 represented into the binary, right? And how minus 25 represent into the binary. Why I am talking about this? Because your computer doesn't understand this plus and minus. This also need to represent in the form of 1 and 0, right? So we'll talk about these sign systems when you represent the sign in the next lecture. So we'll catch you in the next lecture. That's it for today.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, can you please move
thank you, sir.
The screen?
Thank you, sir.
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 Something. Yeah, please go ahead. What?
Sir, like when we are talking about hexadecimal, we are saying that it's 3 bits. So what will we do for decimal system?
Could you please repeat the question?
Sir, वो log लेके निकाल रहे थे ना, तो sir decimal system में फिर क्या 10 का log लेके करेंगे हम?
Okay, you're talking about that. Yes, definitely. Whatever the base that is taking the log. The suppose you are talking about the octal, so log base 8 will be there.
Sir, decimal के लिए भी
log base 10.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Okay, guys, any doubt? Anyone?
No, sir.
Cool. So we'll catch you in the next lecture.
Yes, sir.